Hi friends, please subscribe to Amravati Media and press the bell icon for more latest updates.
We need judges who will protect the rights of the people. Now what do we see in Andhra Pradesh? I don't know how many have read my article last week in the Hindu center page. I have quoted four instances of the Andhra Pradesh High Court going beyond their limits, their power. Today, elected government is fighting for survival, not from rivals, not from political rivals, not from any mass movement, from judiciary itself. An FIR is registered against land scandal, stayed by the High Court. Some people take to social media, make postings, CBI cases are registered, four people are arrested, CBI has gone to America to find the rest of the two people. Now where do we go? A whole judiciary, instead of defending the rights of the people, now doing something different, which is not expected. A division bench, which is hearing a habeas corpus case, they did not file any reply. If a government doesn't file a reply, a department does not file a reply, you can impose a cost. Last month, Supreme Court imposed a cost against the Tamil Nadu government of rupees 1 lakh in a human rights case because they did not file a reply. This is all you can do in a civil litigation. If replies are not forthcoming, you make an ex parte inquiry. The defense of the respondents are struck out. This is all you can do. But a division bench writes an order. By tomorrow, if there are no proper response, we will recommend to the President of India a president role in this state. Where do we get all this? This is what I am now very much worried, because FIR can't be registered, social media postings are intolerated, and president role is sought to be recommended all in the judicial order. I am not saying some off the cuff remark. This is written in the order itself. And now what happens is, elected government brings a bill, whether it's three capital or five capital, we are not worried on that. They bring a bill and it is passed in the assembly. Now that is challenged. Everything can be challenged because it's subject to Article 13. Every law can be challenged and the High Court and Supreme Court can hear any matter. But now when it is challenged, what happens is the full bench, two judges are allottees of land in Amaravati. For the first time, the government files a petition. It is not private parties. As lawyers of the High Court, you know, when a judge is interested, we try to tell the judge, please don't hear the case. He may get angry. But then beyond angry, he can't do anything against the lawyer, because lawyer makes a plea on behalf of the client. The client must get justice from court. A lawyer must have a fearless advocacy, not concerned about the result. But the fearless advocacy is expected of every lawyer under the Advocates Act, under the Bhargavutsal rules. Notwithstanding the result, you should defend your client. Now what happens when judges are interested in a matter, in a direct manner or an indirect manner? When there is a likelihood of bias, you must tell the judge, don't hear this case. They later accuse themselves. Even as a student, at the age of 18, appearing before a commission of inquiry against the death of a student in Annamalai University, I gave a petition to the sitting judge, please don't hear this case. He asked me why. You are an additional judge and this inquiry is against the chief minister, and if you want to become permanent, the chief minister input has to come in your recommendation, and how will you decide the case against him? Please step down. At that time I was not a law student, I was not a lawyer, but as a student leader I gave the petition. The judge asked me, under what law you have filed this case? I told him, sir, I am not a law student, I don't know the law, but I know there is something called conscience. If your conscience is pricking, if you decide for some reason that you can't hear this case dispassionately, please step down. He got angry with me. The commission went on. The commission will never speak to me after a period of 6 months. The commission went on. He will not even look at me. Whatever he wants to say, he'll say through the bench clerk only. At the end of that inquiry, he said, this bench clerk, tell that man to do law, he will do better. That's how he put ideas into me to become a lawyer. But nevertheless, we should not feel hesitant to tell a judge, please don't hear this case. That may be future discretionary orders may be deployed, future benefits may be denied to you, what others are getting may be denied to you. If he is a criminal bail judge, he may not grant you bail. But nevertheless, having taken an oath of office, having got a sanat from the Bar Council, you are expected to fearlessly expose your cause. Now, in the case of this trifurcation of the capital bill case, the government filed an application saying these two judges constituting the full bench should not hear the case because they were allottees of land in Amaravati, which is a very genuine request. It is not bias, it is a likelihood of bias. In my mind, there is an apprehension that I will not get justice.